I don't know if you'll be able to see them on camera, but there's cockroaches running all over the place. Oh my goodness, one just flew past my face, flying a roach. It's pretty dirty here. You can see it hasn't been cleaned up for quite a while. This is where the electricity is coming from. Obviously, there used to be a light post there. They've run wires, taking it across the fence and into these stores here. Who's paying for that electricity? Well, I would assume that that's under the barangay or the city.
Sino gumagamit yan? Pampubliko yan? Tinatap nila yan?
There's cockroaches running all over these guys. I had one on my arm a moment ago. This place is so dirty. Really, really dirty. I'm not sure why the MMDA have to be the ones to clean this up. Honestly, can the barangay not manage this? But for now, they do what they were asked to go here and do. So the barangay will be the ones to take care of this electricity. I'll stand back a little bit just in case this goes wrong. Hopefully he knows what he's doing. I did see someone get shocked before and they were high up on a post. They couldn't let go because the power that was running through them, you know, it makes your body freeze up, right? And then he fell down around 20 feet. He was okay though.
Emergency exit. Pag nagkasunog ang FPU, iaangat to. Hindi ko kasi maintindihan na eh, no? Kung magkaroon ng emergency dito, magkasunog sila. Nakalagay, please do not block the driveway. Paano kaya to?
And yet another basketball court being removed from a public road. Maybe the barangay captain will complain, like the other one before. He said the MMDA are envious. That's why they cleared their basketball court and vendors and everything else that were obstructing the public roads. Oh, is that the barangay captain's car? My goodness. When you come up from this underpass, what you see is a lot of obstructions. Problem is, they were placed here by the barangay themselves. My suspicion is that once the MMDA leave, all of these obstructions might be brought back. But I could be wrong. Maybe they'll keep it clear. It's possible.
Bakit nyo na ginawa ang ano to? Kitchen nyo?
Hindi po yung mga tanod ko pag mag ano
sa kapit. Pero public property yan eh.
It's a lot easier now to see the exit of the underpass. You come out and you don't immediately hit a bunch of obstructions. Will it stay like this? Oh, let's see. I'm not sure. Oh, look, they have a parking over there. Maybe the chairman can put his car inside there. I'm not sure if this guy's just messing around or what, but he knows all the enforcers are here and then he jumped on the bike with no helmet, no shoes. What is he thinking? You can see all the enforcers here. I saw you look at them before you got on the bike and started riding. I don't know if you're taunting them or if you're testing them or you're just something else, right? What are you thinking really? And then the enforcers will be the bad guys if they apprehend you. You'll say, oh, it's unfair. Give me a chance. See that rider in the background? No helmet. Look, two kids on that bike as well. No helmets either of them. This rider's looking at the team and he's trying to decide, should I try and drive through? No shoes, no helmet. The boss had just asked him, did you know there was an operation ongoing here? He said yes. And he asked him, why aren't you wearing a helmet? Some people are self-destructive. I don't know what to say. He knew they're having an operation. He still decided to ride through without a helmet, without shoes. Good morning, everyone. MMDA back on the road. Right now, they're clearing a street of illegally parked vehicles. This area was the subject of a complaint before, and this is a follow-up operation. Here's another example where the vehicle just cannot fit. Look, that's why everyone that walks past is in the road, because you can't use the sidewalk anymore. People often complain, they say, oh, it's not the fault of the driver if they don't fit. No, it is, because you have to make sure you fit before you park there. According to someone nearby, the rims on this vehicle add up to around 200,000 pesos. How can you spend so much on a car, so much on the wheels, and then not pay for parking or modify your property to have a garage? Maybe later someone will complain and say, why didn't you have consideration for the driver? His life. You're talking about consideration for one person, a single person. How many dozens, hundreds or thousands of people are affected by this illegally parked vehicle every day? First lane of the road is blocked, so everyone passing through potentially sits in more traffic. Sidewalk is blocked, so every pedestrian has to walk in the road and hope they don't get hit by passing vehicles. That's what you have to understand. It's the minority that are illegally parked, but it affects the majority, right? The majority are affected. That's why they ask MMDA, can you go here? Can you fix this? Can you clear our streets? It's the same thing with a sedan. Impossible to fit without obstructing the sidewalk and the road. That's why it's going up on the tow truck. See these schoolgirls here walking in the road? Why? Because again, the sidewalk's been obstructed by that parked van. Now there is a way to make it work. Look at this little car here, parked parallel. See, if you park parallel, you won't obstruct the sidewalk, you won't obstruct the road. But if you park like this, well, really there's no consideration. Daddy has a helmet, but mommy and child, no crash helmet, Jan Lang. My goodness, come on, let's put the safety of the kids and wife first. This pickup truck is going on the back of the flatbed now. According to the enforcer, this is the second time it's been towed away. They say the driver lives in the condo building and doesn't have a parking space, so he parks outside on the road. In the past, we've spoken to drivers and they've said, yes, parking is available inside, but we don't want to pay for it. Sometimes they say there's no parking, so it just depends. There is another big sign just nearby which says no parking. I just saw one of the big bikes of MMDA fly by chasing someone that refused to stop. It was a excess passenger, no crash helmet. This driver's complaining because he doesn't want to have his motorcycle impounded. He was flagged down because he has an excess passenger, the small child, and the child doesn't have a helmet, and the driver can't show a license. So they're looking to impound that motorcycle, as well as this taxi over here, for obstructing the public sidewalk. You cannot go past anymore without having to walk in the road. Taxis are required to have off-street parking as part of their franchise. See, this is an example of how it should do. You adjust your private property so that the vehicles can fit without obstructing the sidewalk. You don't use the public sidewalks as an extension of your car park. I've heard a few times that people have said that MMDA don't do any coordination, but actually that's not true. They regularly meet with the city mayors, they do coordination letters with the barangay, which are signed by the barangay. There's so much coordination before they do operations. And most of what they do is based on complaints. They don't just decide, oh, I want to go to this place. They're acting on complaints. On the road in Kalaokan City, having deja vu, this truck has been ticketed and towed multiple times in the past. And likewise, this vehicle has been ticketed and towed multiple times. The driver has even been apprehended for motorcycle violations while rushing here to rescue the vehicle. So until now, he never learned to pay for parking. He prefers to pay for towing. And over here, you'll see they flag down that motorcycle. Daddy has a helmet, but the child on the front and the child on the back don't have any crash helmet. Same thing over here, the rider was flagged down. Daddy has a helmet, but the little girl doesn't.